joining us right now is the UDF candidate, now an MLA, Mr. Shabri Nadin. Sir, you won from the same place where your father won 5 times. CM has said this is a referendum for his government. What is your take?
Definitely, the victory is on a couple of accounts. The one thing, the fact that my father has been doing good work for the last 24 years, people repeatedly gave him a bigger mandate to continue doing the work, the same mandate they passed on to me. Second, definitely the kind of sustainable development that's being done by the UDF government in Kerala. The country wants it, the state wants it. It's a clear referendum on that.
A crucial bipole victory for the UDF in Kerala, the Aravikara bipole, if you can see here right now, complete frenzy here. UDF Congress supporters celebrating outside the counting booth, counting center. Shabri Nadin, the UDF candidate, won with a margin of more than 10,000 votes. It's a huge margin of victory for the UDF in Kerala, specifically in Trivandrum, at a time when UDF has been laden by a lot of corruption allegations from the LDF. And also, the margin of victory is perhaps also time now for the LDF to look within. The LDF has been a divided house in a lot of senses between V.A. Sachidanandan, the opposition leader, and Pinarayi Vijayan, who is heading the state wing of the CPIM. What is going to be their strategy? They had a very seasoned politician as their candidate, whereas UDF, in contrast to that, had fielded Shabri Nadin, who had no experience in politics whatsoever. People might shun Congress for being a dynastic, for a bigger party which has a dynastic politics at its fore, because they feel that Shabri Nadin yet again in Aravikara. Shabri Nadin's father, G. Karthikeyan, had won from the Aravikara constituency consecutively 5 times, and Shabri Nadin himself has won this. But the Chief Minister has said that this is this is a referendum on his performance. He had said this right from beginning. Of course, a huge relief for the UDF here. And as both the parties, the LDF and the UDF, had been looking at the Aravikara elections as a precursor to the local body elections, as well as the assembly elections, which are going to be coming up in 2016. With camera person SP Babu, Sneha Koshi for NDTV.